Hey man, Shane here. I was watching this Revival Fitness video where he takes issue with some of the arguments in Dr. Mike Israetel's Bulking is Dead video, just like I did. And he was making some good points. But then he said something strange.
You see all these guys talk about, oh, well, a 500 surplus a day equals 3,500 a week, which guarantees gaining a pound. No, that is not true. That is not ironclad. The human body is not a calculator. On top of the fact that your overall food quality and micronutrients can really affect this too. But using me as an example, this was my first big bulk on YouTube. I started in September 2020. I did it for 18 months. That's a year and a half. I did a 500 plus surplus. I routinely went over that much because I was feeding my sweet tooth a little bit too much. I liked my chocolate Clif bars and my cereal and my chocolate milk. But I went from 167 pounds up to 190 pounds in 18 months. That is over 500 days. 23 pounds gained. If we use the typical CICO math that we're commonly told, I should have gained 78 pounds, because this was 78 weeks total. That is a 55 pound difference. And people will say, oh, well, you just didn't track properly, bro. It's like, first of all, yes, I did. Second of all, a lot of this was during the initial lockdown period. I was sitting in the house all day, no formal cardio. I ate a ton of sugar and junk food. That is far beyond some miscalculations and some, oh, you didn't account for this little bit of cardio, bro. But all those factors do not account for that level of discrepancy.
If you have a foggy idea of what a calorie surplus is, then what he's saying might sound perfectly reasonable. But there's a glaring mistake here. He's calculating his calorie surplus backwards. And in so doing, he's greatly overcomplicating it. It sounds like what he did was estimate how many calories he burned per day, set his target 500 above that, and then tracked his calories to make sure that he always ate at least that much. That's a perfectly fine way to start a bulk, but you can't calculate your calorie surplus that way. The first problem is that you can't estimate how many calories you burn with very much precision, especially because there can be so much genetic variation between our metabolisms. Take a look at this. I made this calculator based on the standard deviation in these three metabolism studies. It lets you plug in your weight and body fat percentage, and then it tells you the range of calories you might burn while resting. For example, Revival started his bulk at 167 pounds and let's say 12% body fat. Most calculators would tell him that he burns about 1,950 calories at rest, but in reality, he has a reasonable chance of burning anywhere from 1,500 to 2,400 calories. That's a 900 calorie difference. That variation is almost twice as large as the calorie surplus he was trying to get into. And again, these are the calories he would burn at rest. It's not even accounting for differences in activity levels. It gets even trickier because when you start eating more food, your metabolism will probably adapt to burn more calories. So, even if Revival was able to get into a 500 calorie surplus at first, that surplus would probably shrink over time. For example, in this study, the researchers fed the participants 1,000 extra calories per day for 8 weeks. Most of the participants gained 5 pounds, but one gained 10 pounds and another gained less than 1. That last guy was dubbed a hard gainer, and the reason he gained so little weight is that he started subconsciously moving more, spending more time standing instead of leaning, or leaning instead of sitting, or sitting instead of lying down. Those little bits of extra physical activity weren't enough for him to notice anything different, but they were enough to gobble up all the extra calories he was eating. Here's the catch though. Even though he was eating 1,000 more calories than normal, those calories were being burned up. They don't count towards his calorie surplus. His calorie surplus was almost nothing. The second problem is that you can't track how many calories you're eating with perfect precision either. Even if you weigh all your food and use the best calorie tracking app on the market, there's still a fairly large margin of error. And Revival Fitness knows this. I've heard him make similar arguments. That's why it's so strange that he's calculating his calorie surplus backward.
Calorie counting in general is nothing but a ballpark guess. You can use all the calculators online, input all the information, the activity level, all this other stuff. This stuff comes down to guessing.
Fortunately, the proper way to calculate your calorie surplus is much simpler. You don't need to estimate how many calories you burn or track how many calories you eat. You can track your calories if you want, but all you really need to know is how much weight you're gaining. Just to make sure it wasn't me who's wrong about this, I reached out to Dr. Eric Drexler, who studies metabolism at Duke University, and he confirmed it. Your estimated or intended calorie surplus is just that. It's just an estimation. It's just a goal. Your actual calorie surplus is determined by how much tissue you've gained. In this case, Revival gained 23 pounds in 18 months, and let's say he accomplished his goal of gaining an equal amount of muscle and fat. Building a pound of muscle takes around 2,500 calories, and gaining a pound of fat takes about 3,500 calories. Those are rough numbers, but we do have some research showing that it takes most people about 3,000 calories to gain a pound that's an even mix of muscle and fat. So, overall, those 23 pounds take about 70,000 surplus calories to lay down. And he did it over the course of 18 months, so we divide that by 548 days. That gives us a daily calorie surplus of 125 calories, a little bit less if we consider that some of the weight he gained was glycogen and gut contents. That might sound painfully convoluted, but you don't need to do any of that math, and you don't need to track your calories unless you want to. All you need to do is step on a scale once per week to see if you're gaining weight at a pace you're happy with. If you want to slow it down, then eat a little bit less, maybe 100 calories less. If you want to speed it up, then eat a little bit more, maybe 200 calories more. So, if Revival wanted to eat in a 500 calorie surplus, that really should yield a little over a pound per week on the scale. If he's gaining less than that, then he needs to eat more. Otherwise, he's not really in a 500 calorie surplus. Mind you, his 125 calorie surplus worked out great. If he'd been more aggressive and added those extra calories in, he probably would have gained quite a bit more fat. I think he was right to bulk the way he did. He obviously knows how to build muscle. And he had quite a lot of great takes in the video. I especially like this one.
For some people, it doesn't matter. Like, let's say you're 8% body fat, and you're happy with the way you look, and you're happy with the way you look at 22% body fat.
At least mentally speaking, you should be able to be both of those body fats and be mentally sane and content. That's exceedingly rare, it seems like, in the modern fitness scene, but you do want to be able to have a healthy body image and not look on things, whether you are pushing a bulk very hard or on the tail end of a shred. That's a different topic, but it is important.
I agree. You can look good and feel good and be healthy at a wide variety of body fat percentages. And if you're always trying to stay at the very bottom of that range, then it can really throttle your progress in the gym. Here's another take.
I like to tell guys, as long as you're in a state where you're consistently hitting PRs on everything, no matter the rep range, no matter the exercise, whatever it is, as long as you're reliably getting stronger and things are going smoothly, just eat at that point, then once you start to plateau, you can implement a little bit more food. That's as simple as I could put it, without the meticulous tracking and do this and do that. It's very old school, but I believe that it works.
And perhaps most of all, I appreciate how he never forgets to mention us naturally skinny guys.
But on the other hand, if you're talking about going to super bulk mode, you're like, okay, 750 kcal,
yes,
surplus.
You young skinny guys, you may actually benefit from that.
I agree. I think aggressive bulking can work incredibly well for a lot of skinny people. That's how I gained 50 of the 70 pounds I've gained. All right, that's it for now. If you have a comment, drop it below. I do read and answer them. Hope to see you in the next one.